They really have, especially this guy right here. This is Philip Hamilton. You are a senior scientist here at the aquarium, and you have been studying these right whales for nearly 40 years. So you do know them pretty intimately.
Yep, I do.
You do. So last month kind of set a bit of a milestone, marking the 800th entry into the catalog. Can you explain to folks what that is and what that means?
Yeah, so we're actually able to identify each individual right whale by natural markings on their head. And we have been cataloging them for over 40 years. So this was the 800th individual that we could recognize amongst all the whales in the population. It shows sort of the longevity of this project. There are only about 360 that are still alive, so we keep track of the ones even for, you know, sort of history. But the ability to identify individuals is what we know, how we know most of what we know about this species.
Right.
So it's really exciting.
So we're tracking them, and they're in our waters right now. But the fact that they are moving around at our waters near shore at a slow pace, it makes them vulnerable. And so the biggest threats to the right whales are vessel strikes and entanglement. Can you talk a little bit about what the research team is doing with regards to kind of mitigating that a little bit?
Yeah, well, first of all, we actually know that because of our research. Most of the entanglements aren't witnessed, so by knowing each individual and tracking their scarring, we know how many there are. There are a number of solutions for both with the entanglement issue, because they can either be killed instantly or they can be tangled for a long time and suffer. We have the possibility of developing ropeless fishing technology, which is in the works. It's really exciting. It will take a really big transition for fishermen and for the culture. It needs to be supported, but it's a real exciting opportunity. And also, you can use weaker ropes so
right,
that
they
the
might break when the whale gets and they won't get tangled up in it. Yes, so much to learn about these creatures. Climate change, we didn't even touch on that. That is also playing a role as well, but we're out of time, so we're going to continue to chat, but more coming up here from the aquarium throughout the morning. Thank you, Philip, so
Thank
much
you.
For joining
Thank
us.
You.
Antoinette, Jen, we'll send it back to you.
All right. We could